Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to St. Francis Canossian School Chapel, part of Our Lady of Mount Carmel Parish. Today we celebrate the 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. It's also the first day of Sunday school, so we have a lot of family and friends back. So we welcome you. We're happy to see you in the museum here as well. And we hope you feel at home within our parish and the Sunday school and the Mass. Our celebrant today is Father Raymond Li. Throughout the Mass, you can follow along in the Missalette. And we do have the hymn, lyrics, and the leaflet in front of you. We do have a full church today, so please to ensure that we have as many seats as possible. And we ask that you back Mass and your hand back be kept on your lap or on the ground before you. We just talked about raising and lowering kneelers quietly, so children, I'm going to ask you to look after your parents and make sure they raise the kneelers gently and quietly, okay? A special job for all the children. Make sure it's nice and quiet. Please take a moment now to make sure that all mobile phones are either switched off or turned into silent mode. And also, during the Mass, at time of communion, we will have ushers who will show you when to leave your seat and come up and take communion. So just wait for their direction. We'll remind you during the Mass to heads up on that as well. So please rise and sing the entrance hymn, City of God.
Thank you. forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Who can know God's counsel, or who can conceive what the Lord intends? For the deliberations of mortals are timid, and unsure are our plans. For the corruptible body burdens the soul, and the earthen shelter weighs down the mind that has many concerns. And scarce we get the things on earth, and what is within our grasp we find with difficulty. But when things are in heaven, who can search them out? Or whoever knew your counsel, except you had given wisdom and sent your Holy Spirit from on high. And thus were the paths of those on earth made straight. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I, Paul, an old man, and now also a prisoner Christ Jesus, urge you on behalf of my child Onesimus, whose father I have become in my imprisonment. I am sending him, that is my own heart, back to you. I should have liked to retain him for myself, so that he might serve me on your behalf in my imprisonment for the gospel. But I did not want to do anything without your consent, so that the good you do might not be forced, but voluntary. Perhaps this is why he was away from you for a while, that you might have him back forever, no longer as a slave, but more than a slave, a brother, beloved especially to me, but even more so to you, as a man and in the Lord. So if you regard me as a partner, welcome him as you would me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the Holy Gospel.
First, in the Gospel, we can put ourselves
in that scenario of sin, that we become one of those among the crowds traveling with Jesus. And then he turned towards us and telling us plainly, how can we be his disciples? And so he gave us two very essential conditions to be a true disciple, and both of which are quite difficult. The first he says, if anyone comes to me without hating many of our beloved ones, father, mother, wife, children, brother and sister, or even our own life, we cannot be his disciples. I think today's world, no masters will give this kind of condition so plainly. But Jesus, being of always present, can tell us what awaits those who follow him. The second challenge is that to be a disciple, we must face a lot of inconveniences, sufferings, or in the term of Jesus, he calls it a cross. And later in the Gospel of Jesus will explain that this cross is not something that we made ourselves, but the cross or the suffering, inconvenience that come upon us because we believe in his name. Obviously, because we are Christians, so we will have to face a lot of inconveniences. But to be a Christian, we should be honest. To be a Christian, we should forgive. To be a Christian, we should practice justice. But those things, in human terms, oftentimes are unacceptable. It's against our nature for them to love any, But that's the condition put towards us by Jesus. So when the Lord calls us to follow him, it's not the condition laid out only for those priests or religious or the bishops of all of us who are baptized or would be baptized in the name of the Holy Trinity. So it's a big challenge. The thing is, as I said, are we ready to make this commitment? Or rather, are we prepared to continue to be faithful to the commitment that we have made? Because through the very sacrament of baptism, when we ourselves, also the mouths of our parents, we pronounce that the fiat, that is a commitment to the Lord. And that means we are already a disciple. But the thing is, are we following the terms laid out by the Lord Jesus to be a good disciple? For if we want to be a good disciple, one that is truly so, then it involves so many self-sacrifices or sacrifices. I hope all of you are ready and to embrace and these two things, commitment and sacrifice. Over this sacrifice, if it's forced, the value somehow will be diminished. So if we initiate ourselves, and then somehow the reward is great. The reward is great. Then secondly, we turn to this first reading. Why did I say, when we know already our faith, the profession that we have made in the church, why do we have the courage or the trust to make this commitment based on all the terms? But we have our reasoning, right? It's always this commitment is worthy or not. It's a reward and compensate to what I commit. Oftentimes we find ourselves that faith does not really benefit us as much as many of the material things. But what we have in today's first reading, very encouraging for us being disciples in today's troubled world.
The second author in the first reading says, give us a description of God who is high in wisdom and beyond our understanding of times, that wisdom. As he says, who can know God's counsel, or who can conceive what the Lord intends? He is a God of wisdom, and also we know is a God of power. But since the same author tells us, that it's precisely because of this God that we believe in Him, we need also to surrender ourselves into His hands. So our commitment, our surrender, is to God with the highest wisdom. And this wisdom, oftentimes, we cannot understand. It's beyond our knowledge. But if we commit ourselves like what Jesus says, that you should serve me totally with your whole heart, whole mind, and whole strength, then the Lord will save us what we do, what we suffer, or what we enjoy in your disciple. Our Heavenly Father will know it. But in the last sentence of today's first reading says, and thus were the passes of those on earth made straight. The passes of those on earth made straight. Those who are his disciples. Traveling on paths oftentimes are known. Our path is a crooked, a path full of plenty of suffering. And as we say also, that God rides straight through the crooked lines. So this Lord, so powerful, so amazing, and so oftentimes beyond our understanding. So I'm really praying to recommit ourselves to this God that we have embraced. And with this commitment follows those conditions. Self-denial, carry the cross, sometimes even to renounce things that are so dear to us. But another thing I need to explain to you is when Jesus says that you cannot be my disciple without hating your father, mother, wife, children, wife, and husband. Do you think that Jesus is sowing enmity, division in our heart and in our family? Is so or not? Yes or not? Answer. No. You know, the Lord says in the Gospel, I come not to abolish the law, but to complete it. The law is the law. The law in the original form is only the Ten Commandments. And what is the Tenth Commandment? Honoring father and honoring mother. The Lord comes to complete them, to make them to the full, to make them to fulfill according to the will of God the Father. For division, enmity, hatred is never in the teaching of Jesus. So what we can help us better understand the first sentence of this gospel is the last one. It says, so anyone who does not renounce all his possessions cannot be my disciple. You know, possession is a kind of attachment. When we attach to one person, let's say 100%, we cannot give 1% to another one. So it's a kind of attachment. So in terms of loving God, serving the Lord, sometimes we need to make choices. Maybe sometimes we need to make difficult choices to leave aside our loved ones in order to follow the call of the Lord. And this you will hear a lot when you become a priest. Mm-hmm. Some young man or young lady come to you, oh Father, I want to be a priest. I want to be a sister. So you begin to sit down and talk. Are you ready to leave your job, to leave your family, and to go to a country that you never know what will happen there? Some will say, yes, Father, I'm ready, prepared. Before I come to you, I already resigned from my job, very good job. So very determined. So this is a kind of detachment. As these young men, they have no feeling for their parents, of course. They love their parents. But they feel that a strong call from the Lord to serve him. So here comes that term we say, hey. Yeah, hey. There's not a choice that we choose one over the other. But at the same time, we love both. So possessions, attachments. So these are things that the Lord is telling us to make clear, to understand well that which one to choose. So commitment and sacrifice. To choose one, sometimes we need to leave the other. Okay. And to wrap our sharing today, I believe many of you are making commitments. And even the brother told me, today is the first day of the Sunday school in this new semester. So it's a commitment on the part of the parents, on the part of the little kids. I commit myself to join the school, and after how many sessions I don't know, that will be the result. So we know, when we begin these commitments, we know that the result is very good. The thing is that if we follow faithfully what has been presented to us. If we don't, maybe at the end of all the sessions, we don't find enjoyable, we don't find that we are harvesting the fruits that we have committed ourselves. So when you commit to this, of course, you need to sacrifice some other things. So I commit to come to Sunday school at, I don't know what time, 9 o'clock. So you cannot go to, this, let's say, a jogging or walk in the garden. Because we choose one over the other. Like all these commitments, as we said, there is that kind of sacrifice. The same with you in the family, with a husband and a wife. And you committed yourself to one another at the sacrament of the marriage. And how you been faithful to hold up that contract, that commitment, so as to receive the blessing of the Lord. And how you be always ready to make the sacrifices for the well-being of another person. But that's a theme in today's second reading I forgot to explain it. Sacrifice ourselves for the well-being of another person. For example, some Paul send this newcomer, Onesimus, back to Philemon. Some Paul said very clearly, I need him to serve me in my imprisonment. By thinking of you, your reconciliation with him, I send him back. Love him as a son of mine. So on the part of freedom, he also need to renounce or sacrifice something. A slave ran away from him. It's a possession. In that time, he ran away. But according to the practice of that time, he may be killed. Because it's a dishonor to the owner. But now Paul sent him back, love him as a son of mine. A sacrifice for the well-being, the totality of another person. So are you ready to make these kind of sacrifices for the benefit of your wife, your children, your husband, and the well-being of your family? So may the Lord really bless us to be faithful disciples and to be true disciples.
Thank you. We pray to the Father, grant us courage and perseverance so that we may become faithful followers of Jesus, not only in words, but also in deeds. Let us ask Him, Lord of light and strength, hear our prayer.
Lord of light and strength, hear our prayer.
In the church, the community of believers, without the shame of the cross of Jesus, which is the sublime expression of God's power, wisdom, and love, we pray.
Lord of light and strength, hear our prayer.
May our religious and political leaders be endowed with the wisdom to know what is truly good for the people, and the courage and perseverance to bring their work to fruition. We pray.
Lord of light and strength, hear our prayer.
May those who have taken the challenge promoting the gospel values, like Mary, whose birthday we are celebrating today, be not discouraged when faced with adversity, antagonism, or outright persecution. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May those who proudly profess the Catholic faith, but who engage in acts of corruption, violence, injustice, and sexual abuses, see the contradiction in their lives and ask the Lord for the grace of conversion. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we be free from all earthly attachments which separate us from the Lord. And may we be able to develop the gifts He has given to us for the good of all. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, we hear your call, but we fear our inconstancy and weakness. Teach us always to follow you with courage and hope through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated and join in singing the Offertory hymn, Soul of My Saviour.
give us the gifts of true prayer and of peace. Graciously grant that through this offering, we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For your children who scatter afar by sin, through the blood of your Son, the power of the Holy Spirit, you gather them again to yourself, so that the people, formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might to the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifest as the Church. And so in company with choirs of angels we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered in one by the
Holy Spirit. We labor along your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her in fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, coming to John Paul, our apostolic administrator, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have visited you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs in eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Thank you.
supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
Please rise. Let us pray. Grant that your faithful Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit the eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please remain standing for a few parish announcements. Please no clapping at the end of Mass. We do wish to keep the chapel in a prayerful mood. We encourage you to keep the missalette and take it with you. We ask your help to return the psalm sheets to the collection points at the church. Finally, last but not least, please check your seat and ensure you do not leave any items behind. Thank you for your attention. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the power of all consolation order your days in his peace and grant you the gifts of his blessing.
Amen.
And may he free you always from every distress and confirm your hearts in his love.
Amen.
So that on this life's journey you may be effective in good work, rich in the gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and be happy to eternal life.
Amen.
The blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Children and all who wish to receive Father's blessing, please come up to the center for blessing during the recessional hymn. Our recessional hymn today is Let There Be Peace on Earth.